Victory is supported by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Talk about it. Greetings and welcome to Victory here on BCTV. Be informed, be involved. Hi, I'm Tom Frank, the Victory host. We're excited to bring to you live in Studio A a very special event happening this month, and it's to benefit all veterans. It's a special way of saying thank you all for your service. This event is called Redding Stock. It's a throw-off or a spin-off, if you will, from truly what Woodstock was all about in New York State. We have two brothers who are very key involved here in the studio to talk more about it from the committee perspective, the planning, how it was all developed, but more importantly, how you can become involved in Redding Stock. Let's meet our two brothers, the tag team. We have with us Kyle. Tell us about yourself.
Hi. Thank you so very much for putting us on the show to help promote this today.
You're welcome.
Like you were saying, we started Redding Stock with a bunch of bands last year, actually. The question was what were we going to do with all the money that rolled in from people coming to see these eight bands, you know? And the answer unanimously was to give it to a local charity. And I said, well, let's do this as a vet charity thing. And then the question was, well, what vet charity? And there was a bunch of different names thrown around.
Okay.
You know.
Super.
And what it came down to is we all felt we wanted to do something for local vets. And one of the bands had played an event for a charity called Keystone Iron Warriors. And the president came out, met with us, and we were hooked. Sweet. They were the charity. That Sweet. Was it.
Yeah. So that's how that all kind of married together.
And they're not like a lot of these national charities where you have to dig and dig and dig and dig and dig to find numbers or whatever. He literally says, if you want to see my book, I'll open my book. You know, but they provide service dogs to not only handicapped veterans, local veterans, but PTSD,
any kind
of ailment you come back with from the field, you know, and these service dogs are amazing. They're trained to sniff out a PTSD incident 15, 20 minutes before it's happening, and they can tell that it's going to be happening.
Phenomenal.
And then, of course, they're trained to, depending on that vet, whatever brings them back from the brink, you know, that's what this dog will do. They're amazing, you know. And the first thing that came to my mind was a seeing-eye dog, and that's how I related it, you know. But Kyle Hummel, the president of CTI or KIW, he was very quick to say, no, these are much more than a seeing-eye dog. These things go into training at 9 weeks old, and then when they're assigned to a vet, they go through the training with the vet, so the dog, and they get to,
oh my gosh,
it's amazing.
I can't wait to see some of the photos you brought with today and more about the event coming later this month. Let's meet your sidekick, your brother.
How you doing? Thanks for having us.
Welcome, Brad. Tell us about your military background.
I first went in the military in 1990 and got stationed out in California, Fort Ord. You know, and I got out from there, came back, did the civilian life for a little while.
Okay.
Went in the Army Reserves for a while. And then in 2002, after 9/11, decided, you know, it's time to get back into it. And I joined the PA National Guard.
Fabulous.
Got deployed as soon as I came. Went in. I got deployed to Kosovo for a year, and was over there. Came back. Then we went to Hurricane Katrina. We were down there for 42 days, playing down there in the water. And then I did a tour in Iraq in 2008, 2009.
And what division were you associated with?
I was with the 2nd of the 104th Cavalry. The 56th Striker Brigade.
Yes. Okay.
They're stationed down off River Road is the headquarters.
Oh, yeah.
So it was a local.
Okay, good.
You know, that's why, you know, I wanted to get into this Redding Stock thing because it's a local vet.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so I'm trying. This is my first time playing with, you know, volunteering and that.
Uh-huh.
So it's, I think it's going to be a good good thing.
Now, I understand at the event, there's going to be some testimonies from veterans, and I'm sure you'll be one to tell everybody about what experience your walk through your career was as a veteran. And we thank you for your service, and everybody who's tuned in and watching us. We thank all veterans for what they have given to us, the freedom we can enjoy today. And more importantly, we pay honor to those who've given the ultimate sacrifice equally as well.
And that's what the opening ceremonies this year are all about.
That's right.
That's exactly what they're about. It's not only to honor the serving and the alive that actually survived their service. It's not to only to honor them. That's why we want to do a TAPS at the end of opening ceremonies,
right?
Because that is the proper way to pay homage to the fallen heroes that haven't made it back, you know. And there's too many people that take a lot of things for granted.
I'm sure. And this is a good way of focusing it on the home, you know, the home heroes. There's always hidden heroes no matter where you live, and this is just one way of giving it a spotlight to them. Incidentally, in addition to this event, which is going to be on August 27th, that is a Saturday?
Yes.
It's basically almost a 11-hour event. It is. It starts 11 in the morning, and pretty well the last entertainment or group plays until about 11 at night, until they get things all packed up and bring the event to the end. And the big thing is the event you told me coming to the end is where the check presentation takes place on all the money that's raised through this event. We're going to talk about how much money was raised last year. The amount of people that came to the event is phenomenal, and how you can get them all there. And the location, we want to just give you up ahead of time. You can Google it, or you can go to the Facebook page, but it's going to be at 415 Evergreen on Hertz Road.
Yes.
And that's in the Fleetwood Borough. It's the German Club, the Evergreen German Club. That's where it was hosted last year, the same event?
Yes. We've pretty much signed on with them for as many years as they'll have us. I think I was telling you earlier, within 100 miles, it's my favorite outdoor venue.
Really? And you're going to have pictures to show to the home viewers shortly why it's such a great location. I just want to remind the home viewers, you know, we are live here. If you have any comments or questions, you want to call in, BCTV always encourages you to do so. Simply call the number that will be up on your screen. It's the 610-378-0426. Any questions or comments about this event coming up, which is basically Reading Stock? It's to honor and help fund and, you know, money raise for the KIW. That's Keystone Iron Warriors. Mm-hmm. And it's really to help veterans in need. And it's a really fun event. Come out, support it. We're going to talk about ticket prices, how you can, are they able to purchase tickets ahead of time, or is it at the gate?
Of course, we have tickets at the gate. And if we run out, we'll just take your money. You just hand us money.
It works either way. That's true, too.
But if you would like to get them ahead of time, you can contact me personally at...
You have the information that we'll put up on the screen for contact information through a phone number, email, or even a Facebook page they can go to and send you out a message. Or they can like the page, like the Facebook page, and then that way they can keep on updated changes that way closer to the event.
Well, we want people at this so bad, where just like you're saying, in a few minutes or so, we're going to show information on how they can contact me personally.
Yeah.
I will hand deliver. As long as you're within an hour away, I will hand deliver tickets to you. That's how bad I want you there.
Yeah.
Okay?
That's a huge commitment there.
But you can IM the page, Facebook page.
Okay.
Email us, and we'll set something up. You know, we can either mail it out or, because, you know... And this was a major topic of conversation on the board this year, was a lot of people don't want to send a check without getting something first. That whole exchange through various causes has become a little iffy and sketchy. So I said, okay, I love taking road trips. I will deliver.
There you go.
So...
That's a commitment and a promise to you in supporting this great event. Let's look at some last year's photos of this event that took place. It was the first annual, and it was held again at the Evergreen German Club in Fleetwood. And this event raised, I believe you were saying the target goal was $15,000 approximately in one day. And all the sponsors, which we're going to show you later, of all the supporting sponsors that have given so much to this event. Tell us about some of the photos that you brought in today and give us a brief description.
Well, the first one that I wanted to show you was along the lines of what we were talking about earlier and about the check presentation.
Okay.
This young man that's in this photo is actually the founder of Keystone Iron Warriors.
Fabulous. That's great.
He was, at the time that Keystone Iron Warriors was founded, he was 9 years old with autism. Never showed any emotion or any, didn't talk much.
Really?
You know, the
That's
typical.
Unbelievable.
And he went to his father after seeing a commercial on TV and said, "We have to do something." And Keystone Iron Warriors was born. So that's Alex Airborne Hummel right there.
Thank you, Alex. Very good. Next photo.
Well, I have to figure out how to operate your...
Just the energy.
There we go.
Okay.
And another of the check presentation.
Okay.
This was part... This Yeah, the check actually got presented, and we had over $2,000 more come in after the check was presented last year. And we had to actually, repost it 2 days later with the grand total of $15,034, you know.
Congratulations.
But, it was amazing. And on the left in there, that's the president of Keystone Iron Warriors, Kyle Hummel. And then we have some of the band members from last year in there with his event director in the back, Chris Schweitzer, and his lovely wife to the right of Alex Airborne. Is Vicky has, and she's the president or vice president of the board, I believe. I don't want to give out titles because
know. Well, they're just hidden heroes on the board that make this a great success.
Yeah.
Each and every year.
And then we pretty much just have a bunch of photos throughout the day.
Okay.
Now, this first group is photos of the Keystone Iron Warrior people.
Okay.
You know, things like that. And then if I can figure out how to get back to the other folder, we can go to...
Okay, to the next group of photos. While you're doing that, we can also talk about the key aspect of the sponsors. We have a shirt here that we're going to display, and this is really something we want to give a thank you out to all the sponsors that have come out each year, and this is being the second year. This is what makes the event very successful. When you have the support of all these local great sponsors in backing such a great event, and we thank each and every one of them for their commitment and their financial, you know, donations of commitment in every way. The front of the shirt, Kyle, if you want to show the front of the shirt.
Oh, sure.
That's a really neat logo as well. A very great design, whoever did the design of these shirts, so we thank you for the wonderful design. These will be available, of course, for a donation of whatever the cost of the shirt is, which all goes to benefit the KIW and selling these t-shirts, and it gets the word out to everybody.
Oh, let me show.
So if you have the next photo, we can bring that up on the screen and talk more about who's who and move through getting more of a layout of the Evergreen Club. Do you have photos perhaps of the stage area, the parking, which I understand is a huge parking area?
Oh,
yes. Accommodate quite a few.
We had total attendance last year was 792 people.
Wow.
And everybody got a parking space within walking distance.
Now, who do we have in this photo? We have someone that's enjoying, a couple of them enjoying themselves.
Oh, this was just one that was caught. Last year and this year, we had a phenomenal photographer that was just roaming around taking pictures of the day. His name's Davin Sheets. Does a tremendous job with the camera.
Oh, great.
And
he'll
just
be back
caught,
this year.
Yeah, just random shots. And
Who do we have next?
Well, this is one of the band members from one of the bands. And that's what I think the comments we got back, the public enjoyed most was the interaction with the band that you don't normally get.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. Okay. There's a big group shot.
The dance floor is amazingly huge there. I'm talking, you probably could fit 150 people just on the dance floor.
Really?
And that's what's nice about whether it's raining or not, you're outside, but you're inside. You're still under a roof.
You're still under a roof. Yeah. Undercover.
Yeah. Oh, this was some of the most fun we had was the band members. Sterling and MJ from Hijinks, they took the t-shirts around last year, and there was only one. And we're doing it again this year. That was signed by every band member that was on that stage.
Okay.
That shirt will then get auctioned off at the end of the night.
Oh, nice.
But yeah, every band member that was on the stage during the day. And here we have, that's Dave Klein and the Rapport up on stage right there.
Wonderful. This is a great event. KIW, Keystone Iron Warriors. If you're just tuning in, you're watching the Victory program here on BCTV. Be informed, be involved with BCTV and all the programming that is provided. We thank all the sponsors of this event. That is the Reading Stock event, which is going to be happening on August 27th. The doors open, if you will, the gates at about 11 a.m. is the first performance?
Yep. So, no, 11 a.m. the gates open. Okay. First performance will be... Well, then we have opening ceremonies from 12 to 1.
Well, that's right. Let's talk about
that. And the first band will be 10 minutes after that.
We're excited to mention, oh, that's great. Two items adding to the opening ceremony. We have Mastery Gunnery Sergeant Ron Durrell, United States Marine Corps. Yes. Reading native, Berks County. Great volunteering and all he does for veterans. He's coming from Hackensack, New Jersey, where he resides with his lovely wife, Karen. And they will be... He will be involved with the opening ceremonies. He will be rallying of the troops. And Ron makes a great performance as far as his voice projects, and he's a great MC as well. But more importantly, he's a great veteran. So we want to thank Ron ahead of time for making that commitment. And in addition to the Reading chapter of the Vietnam Vets, it's chapter 131. As you know, they're going to be there also, exciting to know, with the color guard and perhaps even playing the taps. That will be at the ceremony as well. Now, this year marks 50 years of the Vietnam War. Mm-hmm. In 1966, when the American troops got really heavily involved, that's really when the clock started ticking, and here we are 50 years later. We were very lucky at the beginning of the summer, in June, to have the Moving Wall Memorial, which is to honor all of the Vietnam veterans who were killed in action, as well as missing in action to this day. We had that half scale here in Berks County at the Jim Dietrich Memorial Park in Muhlenberg, June the 9th through the 13th. How honored is it to have that and then this event and ending up towards the end of summer of Reading Stock, which is to honor all veterans, to raise funds and money for the Keystone Iron Warriors. We have two members of the committee with us, their brothers Kyle and Brad. Tell us about how the closing of this event will take place with the check ceremony.
Well, the plan is, and that's another wonderful thing about the day, we have it scheduled out to the minute, just kind of like you guys run a TV show.
Okay, great.
That schedule changes often throughout the day.
And you'll be making announcements, and of course, the rallying of the troops, I'm excited to see that. And we might also add that BCTV has made a commitment to be there that day, and we will be doing some live taping and interviewing on the event, so that we'll do the editing and bring it to you, the home viewers, for those who may not be able to make that event. If you're out of town, you can still catch it on a future Victory show. We like to spotlight everybody in the Victory Circle to show how victorious this group is, as well as all the groups that we bring each and every year. This marks the 20th year for Victory, and we are so honored to have the Keystone Iron Warriors to be part of that 20th anniversary celebration. And we want to put the spotlight on your group, the veterans, and this great cause. It's going to be a fabulous event. The parking is pretty plentiful, so there's not going to be any issues of having far away, as the case was with Woodstock. They parked so far away that months later they found abandoned vehicles, which some of those vehicles, one is a school bus, they restored and brought it to the museum at Bethel Woods. And there's an honor of a museum of all of Woodstock. And we hope that someday Reading Stock will have a tribute to that event as well. That's the positivity of your growth with this event.
Oh, absolutely. We're looking to grow it to where we need baseball stadiums to hold it. Or
that's a great idea.
Or maybe hey, there's a pretty big farm right across the street from the Evergreen. You never know what could happen. But you know, while we have this laying here.
Yes.
Since it's also an anniversary of yours, and BCTV has been so gracious in having Reading Stock on and everything, this wasn't just for show. I brought this for you.
Oh, well, thank you. I'll be honored to wear it and display it. And if anybody's asking me questions, I'll have a little bit of information to tell them. But more importantly, I'll tell them, be there and be involved.
Just be there and find out. You'll find out everything you need to know the day, August 27th, at the Evergreen German Club. If you want to know what it's about, you'd be there. If you love good music, and we have every different type of music. It's not the same type of music eight different ways.
Oh, I understand.
You know.
Tell us about some of the food vendors that are going to be there, because this is going to be an all-day event, so it's going to be very comfortable for people who come and make the commitment. Do they need to bring any chairs, like folding chairs, if they want to sit out onto the grass, the hillside, or is none of that needed?
Yeah, as you can see in some of the pictures, there's plenty of under-roof seating with tables and picnic tables, things like that.
Is this the food court, the food vendors in this area here?
Yes. The Evergreen German Club is actually donating all food for the entire event. Wow. And there is authentic German food. There's hamburgers, hot dog, you know, your normal stuff that you have.
Yeah.
There is all kinds of snacks. I mean, the list is this times 10.
Yeah, it's endless.
Yeah.
But it's a great time. And of course, the local bands, some of them locally, some are out of state perhaps, but more importantly, they are giving of their talent and their time to come and perform for everybody, to bring in this massive crowd. Are you expecting, this being the second year, perhaps 1,500 to 2,000 people for the day?
That would be phenomenal. Our projection, just to try and keep it humble, was 1,000. If we could top that,
I'm sure you will.
That would be amazing.
It will happen because the word is out. It's happening August 27th, right here in Berks County. We want to thank, a very big thank you to the Evergreen German Club for allowing this event to take place at their facility, which accommodates hundreds of people comfortably of this huge dance floor of 150. We're going to challenge to see if we can get 350 on the dance floor. Well, this is the year to make it grow. This is a year that benefits everybody, including the KIW, the Keystone Iron Warriors. This is really what it's all about, veterans who are in need. And this is a great way to come out and celebrate, have a great fun time, and make it last all day long.
Evergreen German's Club outside capacity limit is 1,800 people.
Wow.
Now, if we could have to turn people away because we hit that limit,
maybe we could move it to the parking lot.
Hey.
If need be. Overflow.
I'll overflow it everywhere.
Now, tell us about
quickly. Long as they'll work with me, I won't turn anybody away.
Oh, that's fabulous. Now, when Ron Durrell, Master Gunnery Sergeant Durrell from the United States Marine Corps, gets the calling of the rallying of the troops, how is that parade going to take place? It's going to take place kind of like in the parking lot as they have a procession parade in to the main stage?
Yes. We were having some issues. I wanted it originally, when I presented it to the board, as a parade from Route 73 all the way up to the club.
Oh, wow. That's pretty fabulous.
We had some permit issues and things like that.
Yeah.
And that's why you have a board of directors, because you need all that input.
They make the decisions.
So, yeah. But we came up with the decision that we were just going to have a procession formed by anybody that comes out for the opening ceremonies, which are at 12 o'clock, you know. So come out for the opening ceremonies.
There you go.
We would like everyone that does that to form a parade route on each side, you know.
Yeah.
Wide enough for the color guard and stuff to get through. And we'll tell everybody where to go. It'll be roped and things like that. And you get a free little stick flag, which I wanted to bring with today.
That's all right. Well, they'll have to come out and get it now to the event. You know, we want to thank everybody with the time we have remaining. First of all, you two, the brothers coming in to talk about this event. And oh, what a great pleasure it's going to be to support the KIW, you know, Keystone Iron Warriors. Both Kyle and Brad has put so much tireless time into it, and all the other committee members who are all the hidden heroes in making this event happen August 27th. It starts at the gate opens at 11 a.m. Plan to spend the whole day. Food and drinks will be out there for your purchase of enjoyment, and it's all benefiting Keystone Iron Warriors. We'll see you all on August 27th. Come out and support all veterans. I'm Tom Frank, wishing all a great Victory Day.